Good evening, YouTube. Just wanted to do another tobacco blender review. Just kind of a quick overview. And that is to the House of Boswell. J.M. Boswell. And you can find them at boswellpipes.com. Great pipes. I've yet to own one. Kind of pricey. But everybody talks about how great their pipes are. There's plenty of review videos and plenty of love for these guys all over tobacco reviews, particularly among aromatic smokers. So do remember that they kind of primarily cater towards aromatics. A couple of English blends that they have, particularly Northwoods, is very popular with the English crowd, and definitely worth a try. I'm not going to give you a review on each and every single one of these that I've tried. It will give you kind of general overview with a couple of exceptions. So located in Pennsylvania, they are very good to deal with and work with. You have to call by phone to place your order. They'll keep your information on file. And so anytime 6 weeks or 6 months later, whenever you want to call back, they'll verify your information. You tell them what you want, they send it out. Very easy. Shipping times, middle of the road there. I ordered something Friday of last week and got it today. It's Thursday, so just shy of a week. But very good to deal with, very good to work with. Fairly prompt email responses if you email them. They're sort of the Lords of Cavendish as far as I'm concerned. It seems like all their aromatics are blended with Cavendish. And I understand that because Cavendish, is my understanding that it takes a top dressing best and sort of gives that flavoring and aroma out a little bit easier than some. Although I've found that not to be the case in some, and I'll tell you what I mean in a minute. In talking about some of their blends, Bear Blend, which is a caramel cherry smoke, I've had that one. Berry Cobbler, sort of a candied fruit. Boswell's Premium Burley, which I've just gotten today and smelled it, and somehow it has a tin note of peppermint patties, if you remember that. So when I smell the tin note, I get the sensation of brrr, tobacco. The chocolate cream is probably their most popular aromatic, and this is one that actually tastes in the bowl like it smells in the tin, at least for the first half. After that, it's the flavoring, the top dressing sort of disappears, but it is good, sort of a dark chocolate or cocoa taste. Pennsylvania Dutch Treat, again, sort of cherry, fruit. Piper's Pleasure, got that in today, and I'm suffering some tongue bite from it. It tastes to me like chocolate cream with a slight coffee flavor to it that sort of disappears mid-bowl again. It tastes very similar to Cornell and Deal's Espresso, if anybody's tried that. And then Railroad Station 965, which I think was their Dunhill match for My Mixture 965, and Northwoods, tried that, which is a great English. If you're an English fan, it's worth trying out. So overall, if you're an aromatic fan, you may very well enjoy it. I would not recommend these tobaccos to somebody who's just starting out. I don't know that I'd recommend any aromatic to somebody who's just starting out. But if you're a well-established aromatic smoker who cares about the room note or who has to have something on hand to go to when everybody's around, Boswell's probably your best bet. Because these do have great room notes. If you're an aromatic smoker that wants to taste what you smell in the tin and taste what the room note is, I don't know that I would say that I could give these guys an endorsement. I think there's some other top shelf aromatics. I've had a couple of Peterson blends recently, the holiday season 2011. And the Summertime Blend 2011 that tasted in the bowl exactly like they smelled in tin, exactly like the room it was, that don't contain Cavendish. And again, Cavendish does not agree with me. For whatever reason, it just destroys my mouth if I'm not very, very careful. Not everybody's going to be that way, and so I'm not gonna fault them for that. It's just my personal thing. I have a hard time with Cavendish heavy blends. These are also incredibly moist on arrival and deserve some drying time. Up to 12 hours probably. Usually if I'm going to smoke one of these, I take it out, take a pinch, put it in a bowl, leave it out overnight, smoke the next morning. That's how much time it requires to dry. Right out of the bag, these things get very hot, very steamy. And again, you know, the Cavendish to me is a bit of a problem. I think some of the better aromatics I've smoked didn't have much, if any, Cavendish in them. So, but overall, very nice. So a plus there, good customer service, big plus. And Northwoods is probably where they, I think that's where their bread is buttered, and I think that's probably where a lot of people get into these guys. The aromatic fans who are well established and know what they want, may find something here to be happy about, may not, might want to stick with some of the other aromatic. But that's kind of my take on Boswell pipes. So tell me what you think. I'm sure everybody has their own opinions about that. Smoke what you like what you smoke. For me, there's better aromatics out there that I don't have the mouth irritation from. So anyway, that's Boswell pipes, and I'll try and do another blender review pretty soon on some of the others I tried. All right, thanks.